Igwe Buike, lecturer at College of Education, Warri, with the topic of discussion on promoting effective basic education, the role of learning and instructional materials.
May I start from the chairman on this occasion? Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, the title of this presentation, like you've been told, is Promoting Qualitative Basic Education, the Role of Learning and Instructional Media. The invitation to lead as a guest speaker in this auspicious launching of an educational foundation was received with a great deal of trepidation. This is largely because it has become crystal clear that provision for education at all levels cannot be left for the governments alone. Considering the fact that education and national development of every country potentiates each other, everything necessary must be done, and all hands must be on deck to maintain a healthy equation between the two. It is no longer controversial that there is an exponential fall in standards of education in Nigeria. Strands of evidence converge to say that this is a truism. For instance, Shell, one of the multinational oil mineral companies, established its own school for graduate employees several years ago to deal with the challenge of falling standard in education in Nigeria. The phenomenon is so biting now that even if the federal government's budget the 26% of annual budget to education as recommended by the UNESCO, there will still be mighty deficit. It is heartwarming to observe that High Chief Government Ekwemekolo and his team of executive members have broken the inertia by assisting Delta State Government and in fact the Niger Delta in general, in the provision of education of some of the citizens through this foundation. The foundation has not only earmarked the largesse to schools and hospitals in some parts of Delta State, but has earmarked the presentation of many materials and equipment. The author has softly chosen qualitative education because it appears more generic and encapsulating than effective education. The purpose of this presentation, therefore, is to lead a discussion on promoting modified materials to read media, because material is an aspect of media. What is education? I pose the question here because people conceptualize education in various ways. And for us to avoid the problem that befell the biblical builders of Tower, there are several ways of conceptualizing education, but one of the simplest but compendious ways is that which sees education as the process of bringing about changes in the way people think, the way they act, and the way they feel. Thinking, feeling, and acting reflect what we generally refer to as cognitive, affective, and psychomotor aspects of educational objective. By implication, education involves head-on, hard-on activities must be presented in their various ramifications and in the right proportion to bring about education. But what our classrooms at the various levels of education have witnessed is the authoritarian dissemination of corpus of knowledge to passive students by teachers who erroneously consider themselves fountains of knowledge. Only the students' heads are partially engaged at the expense of other parts of the body which constitute the human trinity with the head. a vision that is not lopsided enables the individual to have a total development. The individual is armed with resilience of mind, positive attitudes to change, and enabling skills to live peacefully and productively in a dynamic society. Education is an agency of change. Education is an effect of change. Education is a condition for change.